السلام عليكم يا شباب، صباحكم الله بالخير. اي questions او اي concern على اللي صار امس بعد الظهر من ناحيه التريننج سيشن؟ فاي احد عنده ملاحظه او عنده شيء قبل ما نبدا بالسي تي بروتوكول، لان امس الاخوان بداوا يتكلموا على السي تي بروتوكول اون سايت على الماشين نفسه. فالان حاب نعرف اذا كان في اي comments من امس على اساس انه تكون ان كونسيدريشنز بالسيشن الثالث اليوم. فاي احد عنده ملاحظه يا شباب، ما قدر انه مثلا انه يمشي مع الشباب في نفس اللاين، كانت في صعوبه في موضوع البروتوكولات، تفضل.
السؤال كان حول السلايس، هل تكون نبدا في ثين سلايس ولا ثيك سلايس؟
طيب
بعدين نسوي منها ريفورم.
طيب اوكي،
ايهم افضل يعني؟
طيب ممتاز.
هذه الشباب بلغوا انه ما في مور راديشن يصير.
طيب هذا الفيرست وان. السكند، اي كونسيرن ثاني؟ طيب سو فار انه ان شاء الله اوكي. هذه ويل جو ان ديتيلز. الان السيشن اللي حيبدا الان هو سي تي بروتوكول، ف ويل جو مور ديتيلز على كل البروتوكولات اللي 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 حتكون، وحناخذها ان ديتيلز. يعني ابراهيم حيبدا، اذا في شيء بعده احنا حنكون موجودين انا وخالد. في اي كونسيرن على البروتوكولات نفسها حنعطيك اياها كلها كامله ان شاء الله، بس ما نبي نستبق على اساس انه ابراهيم ياخذ التايم حقه كله كامل. سيشن ثاني او كويشن ثاني او كونسيرن ثاني؟ طيب ابراهيم جو اهيد.
So if you have any question, you can stop me at any minute. Okay, I will cover inshallah those outlines. I will go through CT scanner generation, types of scanning, CT detectors, artifact, preparation, and contrast media. Then we'll go through a quick view. Then we'll start to the CT protocols. Inshallah, I will not take very long time. So what is CT? All of us, we know that CT is a term that related to the computerized tomography. And tomography is a Greek word that means motion. And it is a medical imaging device that we can get images in a cross-sectional without superimposing of any other tissues or any other tissues or organs. For CT generations, we have fourth generation in CT. The first one, the second, third, and fourth. They can differentiate it by the CT data acquisition and how many detectors they have. If I will say translate, that means this is the tube, this is the body, and this is the detector. Translate, that means we're putting the tube up, detectors down, and this is the body. Then I will take cut, then I will move it again, take cut, I will take another cut, I will take another cut. That means translate, motion. Then I will say rotate, I will rotate the tube, then I will take other cuts again. This is was in the first generation, and it have only one scintillation detectors. The second one, same data acquisition of the first one, but there is multiple array of detectors. The third one, which is rotate continuously, and there is arc array. There is a lot of detectors which is move continuously with the tube. The fourth one, it's rotate continuously. That means the same data acquisition of the third, but there is a circle array. Whole gantry is fixed with fixed with the detectors. So the first and second same data acquisition, and third and fourth same data acquisition. But the difference is in the detectors. So which one we are using now? Sam? Third one? Okay, we are using now the third one, but why we are not using the fourth one? It's same as the third, but all of the gantry, they have all those detectors. So only the one which is rotating is the tube only. Anyone have an idea? Sam? Very expensive, yes. Another thing? scatter radiation. Scatter radiation coming to the detectors. That means the detector will have the signal twice. Okay, then this is what will affect the image quality. So what we are using now is the third generation only. This is an example of the first generation. This is the body source, and that is the detector. This is also, just to make it clear for you, this is the same X-ray tube scintillation detector, and this is the body. This is how I told you before, the translate and rotate. Translate, that means it's taking cuts. Okay, then we are rotating the tube, then we are taking cuts again. The first generation, they said it take more than 6 hours to finish brain. This is the first generation image, and the radiologist was happy about the quality. Okay, this is the second generation. We have one source, but we have multiple detectors. Same, translate, then rotate. This is the third generation, what we are using now. Source with the detector, they are moving continuously. And this is the fourth generation, where we have fixed array of detectors, and we have only one source. Okay, how many types of scanning we have? Two types, okay? The first one, we call it conventional slice-by-slice acquisition, the axial one. And the other one is the helical spiral. Conventional slice, if you are putting axial scanning in your machine, you will have this diagram, right? This diagram, sorry. What's that mean? This one mean table movement, and this one mean X-ray. Okay? We are not anymore using this one unless we are monitoring for contrast in the smart prep. All of the hospital, I think, a lot of hospital now, they are using it for scanning of a brain. No one is using this one because it's taking a long time, and it is difficult to do 3D reformatting, and there is misregistration of data, and we cannot do coronal and sagittal with it. Supposed to be helical. All the scanning should be helical because it is very fast. You will get eliminated from the motion artifact and the breathing artifact. This is the helical spiral volume scanning, which is there is a continuous movement of X-ray tube with a continuous motion of the table. The characteristic of the spiral scanning, continuous movement of patient and X-ray tube, there is increased cooling capacity, and there is a large mass buffering which is coming to the detectors and should be detected by the PCs. The slip ring technology, this is the technology which has made the engineers to have the third generation. So the tube and the detector moved without wires. If we are saying beach factor, what we are meaning by beach? Anyone have an idea? Sam, what is beach? No, it's not the table. Anyone have an idea what is the beach? It's not target area. Okay, we have. If you are reading the number of the beach, what's that mean? No, it's not field of view. It's always coming like number, then two dots, then other number. That means there is a ratio between two numbers. So it is the ratio between CT table move during one revolution of X-ray tube. Each one revolution of X-ray tube with the ratio of CT table movement, this is the beach factor. So if you are increasing the beach, that means the coverage will be faster than the smaller beach. But the dose here will be less. The dose here will be concentrated. The dose here, you will lose data. You will lose the quality of the images if you are increasing too much more than what you need. Like if you are scanning a brain and you put it for high beach, that means you will cover the brain within 3 seconds, but you are losing the quality of the images. So it depends on the area you want to scan. So always the higher beach is scanning for chest, abdomen, pelvis. But we are not going for the highest one. If you are going to the highest one, that means you need to compensate in the MA, and the machine, it might not give you that the desired MA that you want. سم طيب هي نسبة ما بين كل ما يلف التيوب دورة واحدة كم من نسبة اللي تتحرك فيها الطاولة كل دورة كاملة كم تاخذ فيها الطاولة عشان تتحرك انت اللي كانت الاريا تحتاج فيها higher quality طيب تحتاج ان البيتش يكون شوي صغير اذا تحتاج 3D images processing 3D it shouldn't be very high it should be optimum and it should be optimum for all of the scans واضح this is the difference this is for lower beach and this that one is the higher beach if the beach is increased the scan time exposure and quality of the images will be reduced and scan time scan complete in short time. Scan can be completed while single breath hold. Improve 3D images. Reduce motion artifact. Small lesion detection. And effective different respiration level are removed. And reconstruction in any plane. There is also another factor which is called noise. What we are meaning by noise? Noise. Okay. What? Grayness, okay. Okay, this is right. This is but what is affecting the noise? It's misregistration of the CT data. That means you are not giving an optimum dose to the patient to get detected by the artifact. Okay, always this is affected by the MA. If the MA is really low, this is why you have noise artifact. This is the phantom. This one, the one which is in the left, this is higher noise, while the one on the right, this is optimum noise. And like what we are saying yesterday, if you have noise index, you are putting it higher. That means you are widening your window. You can play by the MA. It will give you differentiation in the MA. But if you are making the window very small, that means you will give the patient, it will go with the higher radiation because you need more penetration, you need more quality to the patient. the CT detectors got some, CT X-ray detectors got some characteristic, which is should be high capture efficiency, absorption efficiency, conversion and stability dynamic range. If we have two type of the machine. One is 16 slice and the other one is 64. What is the difference between them? Is the dose to the patient same or not?
For example, if you want to do the pain at 64, it's will finish the studies so quick, and the other one it should be less timing than.
Okay, less timing than the 16. You mean? Okay, another thing about the dose. As per the medical physicist, they said the dose it is the same for the tissue of the patient, but the dose is increased to the technologist. So this is why if you have 64. You should apply more lead to your room. Okay? And what is they are playing now with the detectors? They said we have a high capture detectors. That mean if you are using low MA, all of that MA will be detected. Like what they have in gemstone spectral imaging. In gemstone detectors, it is high capture efficiency. This is why all of the data get being recorded in the detectors. Okay, before we have gantry angulation, and why we have angulation because we want perpendicular slices to the organs, and we are applying angulation during sometimes during biopsy. and their images plans. This is not an MRI, not like MRI. MRI, you can scan the patient in all of the planes, while in CT, you should have a software to have coronal and sagittal. And we talk about type of scanning, advantage of scanning, and contrast resolution. It's 30 times greater than the general radiography. So spatial contrast and soft tissue resolution is better in CT. Okay, and what is CT numbers? CT number is linear attenuation coefficient assigned to a digital representation. So they said the zero is water, and whenever you are going higher, that means you are going through the bone, the images will become whiter. While you are coming down to the air, it will become minus 1000 to become darker. Before the radiologists, they are measure, until now, we are measuring the density, the Hounsfield unit, to know what is this lesion exactly, right? So CT artifact, we have motion artifact. How we can reduce this motion artifact? Yes. Yes. No, this is motion artifact.
Motion for the brain?
No, for anything. Motion artifact. Sam? No, how you get eliminated from the motion artifact? What? Reduce the time is one of the issue, but maybe you need to use that time. What is IM? This is motion artifact, guys. I said how you will eliminate the motion artifact. كيف احنا نقدر اننا نبعد الموشن ارتفاكت؟ سم؟ نو. نو نو ذيس از موشن ارتفاكت مريض تحرك هذا موشن ارتفاكت. How we get to illustrate the exam for the patient. Okay? And if you think that the patient will move, don't do the scan. You have another thing, like to ask for sedation or under general anesthesia. Don't expose the patient while you know that the patient will move. If you know the patient will move or he got claustrophobic from the CT, try for another way. Yeah. Yeah, don't scan the patient if the patient will move. Don't scan the patient, don't expose him to the radiation. This is the metallic artifact. This is inside the body, so no one can get, no one can take it out from the patient. But by the dual energy, we can get out of this artifact. This is the noise artifact. The images have been noisy because there is a low MA. This is the ring artifact. Ring artifact always coming from, they say it's coming from the detectors. But until now, you didn't see any defect detectors. It happened always if the machine didn't do warm up for it in the early morning, or your KV, the penetration is not sufficient for the patient. Beam hardening artifact, if a patient got any hardware, got any implants, this is also we can get rid of by using the dual energy. CT preparation, we talked about CT preparation yesterday with nurses, if it is emergency patient, inpatient, or outpatient. We go through it yesterday in details, and if you have a patient with RTA, as what you said yesterday, road traffic accident, and if you are going to give contrast, no need to check anything with the patient. No need to check renal profile, EGFR, creatinine, nothing. Just to put the patient and scan. Okay? And always make sure for any female patient about the pregnancy. We have using a lot of, there is a lot of contrast media we are using. It's depend on your protocols in your hospital. About which one you can use. Either is it OmniPake, VisiPake, and the other one, there is Zenetix also. What is the difference between concentration? You have 300, 320, 350. I think that Zenetics, they have 370, right? So what is the difference in the concentration? Less in what?
Sorry?
Less in what?
In the concentration.
Okay. What? Less enhancement. Okay. What else?
Maybe I'm not sure. Maybe it's 320. Maybe it will give us more details in the end
cases. طيب. Yes. Right. Okay. أنا دائما أشرحها للستودنت.
لا 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 ما لها دخل.
If it is calcification in the kidney or anything happen to the patient, that means this contrast is not used to be, is not useful to be, not safe to be used with the patient. You don't want to harm the patient. You want to give the patient benefit. The benefit should outweigh the risk, always in anything. Okay, أنا دائما أشرحها للستودنت أقول له عندك كاسة شاهي. طيب 300 ذا بدون سكر. 320 سكر وسط. 350 هذا حالي مرة. Always illustrated for the student. This is kind of tea. 300 is without sugar. 320 that mean a little bit sugar. And the other one that means it is full of sugar. That mean less amount of the 350 will give you the desired enhancement about what you want. Okay? Before I go to the abdomen protocol, how many person work on Siemens? How many person work in GE? Just okay, one technologist, not radiologist. How many person work on Siemens machine and how many person work on GE machine? GE machine, how many person? Yes, for both? Both, okay. There is MA in both machine or not? Yeah, you have MA in your Siemens? You have MA? You have MA? You have MA in your Siemens? Sure. Okay. GE, you have MA? Okay. VMA. Sure, it is MA. Okay. There is a problem and miscommunication between these two manufacturers. The Siemens are not using MA, like it will not tell you this is MA. If you are using 300 and you put it 300 in the MA of Siemens, this is not. Why? In Siemens it's written effective MAS. That means this is not the real MAS. If you will send it to the PACS, check the MA there written. It's not the same what you are choosing there. What's that mean? Effective MAS, it is the MA multiple second over the beach. So 90 effective MAS and protocol which is have beach of beach of 1 and rotation time of 0.5, that mean in Siemens machine, this is, it's mean around 200 MA and you are putting only 90. Got it? طيب. Siemens machine ما تستخدم MA كقيمة. ما تحط انت القيمة نفس الGE. الGE عندك MA and you put the number. Right? For Siemens, not. It is effective MAS, which you should do the calculation. Have your MA what you want, like 300, then multiple by the rotation time, then divide it over the beach. This is the effective MAS, then you will apply that amount. Difficult? It's tricky. طيب, if we'll solve it, inshallah.